Pearltrees is a free online tool that enables you, and most importantly your learners, to organise, explore and share their research, web pages, images and files, and network their learning with a whole community of Pearltree users. That's coming up in today's Tuesday Tech Tip. Firstly, head over to pearltrees.com and sign up for a free account. Once you've signed up, the next thing you need to do is install the free Pearltrees Web Clipper extension. This is going to enable you to grab any web page you need and store it in a Pearltrees collection. Just click the Install Web Clipper button and add the extension to Chrome. And now we're all set. The first page you're taken to is your Pearltrees homepage, and this is where you'll keep your collections. So we need to create a collection for our resources to go into. Let's say we're teaching on a Level 4 HNC in Construction Site Supervision. Your learners could create a collection for the whole course for them to collect research into for various units. So we'll create a parent collection for this called Level 4 HNC in Construction Site Supervision. We can give it a description, so my collection of research materials for my site supervision units. And we'll change the image. We can upload our own image or we can search on the web from inside Pearltrees. Just search for Site Supervisor. Once you've found an image you like, just click on it to make that image the album cover. We can also make the collection private if we've got a premium account, but we don't, so we'll just click the Add button. So you can see we've now got a new collection with an image for our Level 4 Site Supervision course. Click on the image to open the collection. Okay, from here we can begin adding resources to this collection, or we can add another layer of organisation. Say a collection for each of the units we'll be covering. Click on the plus icon and make sure collection is chosen, and title the collection the name of the unit. So the first one is Unit 1 Individual Project Pearson Set, and we can choose an image for the collection. Add the next unit in the same way, so click the plus icon and name the collection and find an image for it. Unit 2 Construction Technology, and continue adding units in this way. Once you've created some collections, you can reorder them by dragging them into position. Okay, so for this task, we'll be creating research for Unit 3, Construction Science and Materials, and in particular, Learning Outcome 2. Discuss the environmental and sustainability factors which can impact and influence the material choices for a construction project. We've set the learners the task of defining the difference between non-hazardous and hazardous waste. So the learner would search the internet for the difference between non-hazardous and hazardous waste. Straight away we find the HSE definition of hazardous waste, so we'll clip that into our Unit 3 collection. Click the Pearltrees extension button and then choose the collection for this to go in. We've got a drop down arrow that we can click into to drill down to the correct collection, and we click Unit 3 and there we go, it's been collected. Okay, so let's go back and continue our search. We've got a government site here with waste classification, so we can clip that as well. You can also clip YouTube videos in the same way. Just find the video you want to clip and use the Pearltrees web clipper to grab the video. If we click the C button when we clip a website, you're taken back to your Pearltrees collection and you can see the sites that we've clipped so far. You can also preview the YouTube video from inside Pearltrees. As well as clipping from the web, you can also upload your own documents and images by clicking the plus sign and choosing the corresponding icon. So we're going to upload a document to our collection. It takes just a few seconds to upload and you can preview the document or click it and download. You don't just have to work from a computer to use Pearltrees, there's also a mobile app you can download too. Now creating collections are great, but where learning technology like this really comes into its own is when learning can be networked. Pearltrees creates that network for you. Firstly, it will notify you if there are similar collections to yours that exist using keywords from your collection title. You'll see a red number appear here. If we click on the My Recommendations button, you can see recommended collections that Pearltrees offers based on your own collections. You can also search Pearltrees for related content up here. We'll search for waste management. It gives us some of the collections that others have created. Just click on the collection. And if you find individual content you want to add to your own collection, just hover over the image and click the plus sign that appears and choose the collection you want to add it to. If you want to add somebody else's whole collection to your own, click the subscribe button and choose the collection you want to add it to. And we can see here that we've got content we've clipped and a whole collection of waste management related content in just a few minutes. Finally, we can collaborate on collections with our peers if they're using Pearltrees by clicking on the team up button and inviting them by email. This way, multiple members of a group can network their research and collaborate in teams, turning just one researcher working alone into a connected, networking learner, expanding their collective resources way beyond what would be possible working alone. Now, once we've collected all of the resources and research, higher order thinking is then needed to work through this material and choose the most relevant, useful, and accurate information. I'm using Pearltrees on a daily basis to collect interesting articles and resources on a wide range of subjects. Give it a go for yourself, and once you're comfortable with it, get your learners using it. You won't be disappointed. Well, that's all for this week. If you've got a tool that you think I could share with our community of educators, then just drop me an email or connect with me on LinkedIn. See you next week for another Tuesday Tech Tip.